Hi, I'm Kieran,
and this is our review on the H&K 416, made by JG.
And I'm going to hand you over to Matt, who's going to give you a quick overview of the gun.
Okay then, this is a general overview of the JG H&K 416. Okay then, let's go. Okay then, we'll start from the stock. The stock has six positions. This is one, that being six. Pretty good, apart from there's a little wobble now and again if you run into a few trees like I have. Okay then, there's a sling. There's a
sling point.
Shazer. Yes, there's a sling point here. It's pretty high quality. It's made of metal. You can trust it. It's not like most guns where it'll just snap off. Okay, there's this button here, which, to be honest, I have no idea what it does on the airsoft gun. I mean, on the real 416, it probably does something a bit more useful. The sight, which comes as standard, is full metal, it's really heavy, and it's got different positions. So if I shoot like this, number one is for more of an accurate shot, and number four, you know, it's more of a random spray and pray type of thing, cracking off there. Alright then. The dust window here on mine is broken. I think it was because I collided with something not so long ago and it sort of snapped it off. But usually, when you pull the normal cocking mechanism back on the real gun, that releases this, and then obviously this exposes the hop-up system in there. If you can see that. Alright. Cool. Okay. The mags, this is a standard mag, but I have got more here. These are D-Boys mags. These are pretty good. I think they're 350 rounds. The wind up, the high capacity, obviously, 350 rounds, quite a lot of bullets. Okay, to release the mag, there's a nice little button here you push. It usually just slides out, but actually sideways, it won't. Cool, right, okay then, moving up the gun. There's a battery box. This specific model is like model number one, really. I mean, there's other models where there's like a full stock and the battery's in the stock itself, but this one's a retractable stock, so they've had to find a place to put the battery, so it's here in the battery box. On this battery, this gun here, this is Kieran's. He's put his battery box on the side because he's, you know, used it to put a bipod here. Not a bipod, what am I saying? A vertical grip. And his can actually come off as he's taking his out a few times. You just pull this without doing that, and then you can actually take the battery out. But we've wedged it in with an Allen key, so there's less wobble, because it does wobble a little bit, and it's quite good. You know, you've got a little toolbox in there, maybe. Got stuff like that. Okay, that's cool. Hang on. Right, moving up. The 416 is really, really versatile, because you've got all these 20mm rails here, or RIS rails, I think it's called. So you can put a lot of accessories like lasers, ACOG scopes, whatever takes your fancy, really. But one of them has to always be used to house the battery box, which is kind of annoying. At the very end of the gun here, we've got a flip-up iron sight, which goes quite nicely with this iron sight here. It's like flip-up and down, so if you want to put like a nice scope here, it's not in the way. This is the other sling rest loop thing. This is full metal as well, so you can trust it with your gun. It's not like a normal one. And the very end's a flash hider. This does come off, but you have to cut your fingers and everything to get it off. It's really heavy, alright? So, these are the guns, and that is it.
Hi, I'm Matt.
Hi, I'm Kieran, and now we're going to be doing a shooting test on the JG H&K 416.
The gun shoots around 375 feet per second at an accurate range of over 60 feet.
Right, so now we are going to do our shooting test at 30 feet with the JG 416s times 2 in full auto.
Let's burn some CDs.
So now, in the spirit of Easter, we're going to own an Easter egg.
Let's do that.
Looks tasty.
Oh dear.
That Easter egg got owned.
Yeah, I want some though.
The taste of defeat.
Hi there, and now we're going to do the metal content on the JGHK 416. So here on this gun we have the left hand side. So we're going to start from the buttstock, and from the buttstock there is the metal sling attachment. Then this bolt here, which is irrelevant really, and the bar, which is for the retractable stock. Now going forward, we have the fire selector, that is metal. Trigger guard and trigger is metal. And the bolt catch, which isn't working by the way, it don't work on any of them, that is metal. We'll go to the top, we have the charging handle, that's fully metal. And here is magazine release on the other side. You can't really see the RIS on this side, but there is four of them going all the way around. The whole front of this, which makes it quite front heavy, is metal. So now we're going on to the right hand side. So you've got the same thing, except we've just got the little indication of what you're in, which is always on semi-auto. And then we have the button for the trigger, for the magazine release. Then we have the dust cap. And same again with all the metal and the trigger and the sight. And on Matt, he has the original sight, which to show you properly, and if you can see down it, you've got four, which is a spray and pray, as Matt said, going down to three, two, and one, which is a more accurate shot, but this gun isn't really that good at accuracy. It's better for a spray and pray. So that's about it for all the metal content. So have fun watching this video, hope you like it, and comment, rate, and hope you subscribe.
Right then guys, I'm going to do the shooting test with the H&K 416. You got a feel for Matt, because he just took the SW40F, and he's now volunteered to do the 416. So I think this guy is very strong, and he's going to take a few hundred shots with this gun. First we're going to do it in semi-auto. Let's zoom in to the pain. Oh, dear. Oh no, oh Matt. Come on, Matt. Oh dear. You ready for full auto?
No.
No, you want to take some more?
Yeah. Testo.
Matt's took so many bullets that the magazine's running out. Stop! Do you want to go full auto?
No.
No? You done?
Yeah. Oh my god.
Well done, Matt.